welcome to my channel. My name's Ksenia. I'm an artist, a gardener, and a book lover. Here you see my zinnias behind me, which pretty much sound like my name, so it's natural that I should be growing them. Today is a Poetry Monday episode. I hope you're having a lovely Monday, and I hope that these poems will touch you in some way. I'm actually doing a kind of a theme more than just one specific poet. It's both a specific poet, Mary Oliver, and a theme, loss, and specifically the loss of a pet. Recently, I lost one of my bunnies. It had to be put to sleep because of paralysis, and it seems like such a small thing, I guess you could say, because, you know, a pet isn't human, but there is quite a lot of grief still, because it's so innocent and it's been loved, you know, for so long that it's hard losing it. So I wanted to return to one of my favorite poets, Mary Oliver, and reread her poems on her dog and grief. So yeah, I'll be sharing a couple quotes and three full poems. And it is exceedingly short, his galloping life. Dogs die so soon. I have my stories of their grief. No doubt many of you do also. It is almost a failure of will, a failure of love to let them grow old, or so it feels. We would do anything to keep them with us, to keep them young. The one gift we cannot give. A dog comes to you and lives with you in your own house, but you do not therefore own her, as you do not own the rain or the trees or the laws which pertain to them. A dog can never tell you what she knows from the smells of the world, but you know, watching her, that you know almost nothing. And now my old dog is dead, and another I had after him, and my parents are dead, and that first world, that old house, is sold and lost, and the books I gathered there lost or sold, but more books bought, and in another place, board by board, and stone by stone, like a house, a true life built, and all because I was steadfast about one or two things, loving foxes and poems, the blank piece of paper and my own energy, and mostly the shimmering shoulders of the world that shrug carelessly over the fate of any individual that they may, the better, keep the Niles and Amazons flowing. It's from one of her essays in Upstream. So these are the poems about the dog. I ask Percy, the dog, how I should live my life, by Mary Oliver. Love, 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 says Percy, and hurry as fast as you can along the shining beach, or the rubble, or the dust. Then go to sleep, give up your body heat, your beating heart, then trust. The sweetness of dogs. What do you say, Percy? I am thinking of sitting out on the sand to watch the moon rise. It's full tonight. So we go, and the moon rises, so beautiful it makes me shudder, makes me think about time and space, makes me take measure of myself. One iota pondering heaven. Thus we sit, myself thinking how grateful I am for the moon's perfect beauty. And also, oh, how rich it is to love the world. Percy, meanwhile, leans against me and gazes up into my face as though I were just as wonderful as the perfect moon. Little dog's rhapsody in the night. He puts his cheek against mine and makes small expressive sounds. And when I'm awake or awake enough, he turns upside down, his forepaws in the air and his eyes dark and fervent. Tell me you love me, he says. Tell me again. Could there be a sweeter arrangement? Over and over, he gets to ask. I get to tell. Oh, that's so beautiful. There's something about loving an animal that's just so unconditional and so loving and so open that just the innocence and the purity of that relationship, it feels like a betrayal. Letting an animal die, seeing it suffer, having to put it to sleep, it feels like a betrayal of its trust, but seeing it in pain and knowing you can ease its suffering is its own kind of responsibility not to be taken lightly. Those are just a few of her poems. She actually has a whole book of dog poems, but I never got around to getting it because I've never had a dog. I've only had birds and rabbits and guinea pigs and other small animals. So I should get it. When I get a dog, I will get her book of dog poems. But yeah, if you have a pet, don't forget that there are always poems about your pet, about bunnies, about anything, literally any kind of pet, you can find a poem. And it's sweet and somehow like just relatable to read about a relationship with an animal when you're enjoying your animal so much. There are a lot of lessons to be learned from an interaction with your pet, with your animal, and she puts words to it so beautifully, of course. You can also find like YouTube videos of her reading them out loud if you're interested in that. I'll probably put a link down below. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you haven't read Mini Oliver before, you should definitely check her out. She's a relatively contemporary writer. She died in 2019, and her work is amazing. I just love her. I don't even know how many books of her I have, but more than a dozen. Anyways, I hope you're having a lovely Monday, and I will be sharing another Poetry Monday episode next Monday. Until next time, bye.